In this video, I'll show you the body drag in and out. I will cover why and when to do it, what's the objective of this body drag, common problems, and how to fix them. Also, I'll show you the key points to do it correctly. My name is Thiago Rocha, and if you like these videos, please click the subscribe button or activate the notifications to find out when the next video is released. Also, leave a comment about this video, any recommendations or questions in the comment section below, and I'll make sure to get back to you. Body drag in and out. Why and when? This body drag type is the first one you should learn. It's the one that will enable you to go out of the beach perpendicular to the wind, as covered in other posts. You should practice with side on or side shore wind direction. This technique will allow you to go away from shore and come back again, probably a bit more downwind. It's impossible to practice in the shore break, so going through the waves into the outside before practicing other exercises or just going out riding is essential. For this, you have to learn how to do this technique correctly. So what's the objective? The objective of this body drag is to get you used to have your body under control when dragged by the kite. The pull should be constant, and you should not rotate your body all the time. It's to be done with a low pull from the kite, and the kite in a static position. It's also the time to learn how to keep your kite controlled and static. This should be done while the kite is pulling you through the water. Common problems and how to fix them. One of the main issues with this exercise is the fact that often you start trying with the long lines, allowing for the kite to have more space to move, as this exercise should keep the kite static. The short lines help. Key objective is to keep the kite on one side of the wind window and only change one time when you decide to go back. Make sure when the kite passes by 12 position, you push the bar away from you to depower it completely. Another problem is the body rotations. Since the kite is pulling to the side, I recommend you to go on your belly in a swimming position and keep your arms on the bar. As the kite pulls you, you will have your upper torso out of the water and it should be easy to steer the kite. To help stabilize this position, I recommend you open your legs so it's harder to turn around. Key points. Lay down on your belly and grab the bar with both hands, placing them in the center of the bar near the central line. With the kite in the air, the center line will be where the force is transmitted, so you'll maintain a float. Try to keep your head away from the bar and out of the water. Like this, you can get a good view of the place you are heading. Try to balance this position by opening your legs, keeping your body from rotating. Keep the kite on one side of the wind window and try to stabilize it. Keep it around 10:30 or 1:30. If the wind is strong, you can keep the kite lower in the wind window as it will help you. Also, if the wind is light, then it's better to keep the kite higher, but please make sure you do not change sides all the time. When you decide to change direction, make sure the kite always goes by the edge of the wind window and that it passes 12 o'clock position. When it's passing the 12 o'clock, the bar should be all the way up, making the kite completely depowered so you aren't dragged downwind a lot. This is one of 5 videos covering all the types of body drag that you should know and master to become an independent kite surfer. Let me know if you have learned and mastered this one. If you had or have any difficulty doing it, let me know on the comment section below so I can try and help you out. Click here to see another video and here to subscribe to the channel.